to her. Let's talk to this guy first. Actually, who do I talk to first? All right, we'll talk to him.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, my dear man. I was led to believe that you're a doctor.
None of the residents of this establishment are among my patients, sir.
Oh, you're not here as a doctor, but as a man, then. I understand. This is my kind of place, too. It's in these houses in Whitechapel that you find the girls that are the most natural.
Yeah, big hands.
And definitely the most docile.
Your way of speaking about these women is not that of a gentleman, sir. I heard that you were the victim of a robbery here.
Oh, I'm not complaining. The loss of that walking stick will certainly bring me a very pleasant compensation.
What does your cane look like?
The stick is ebony, about 35 inches long. The round knob is made from chiseled silver with a ring around the middle of the same workmanship, just like the tip, for that matter. If you find it, don't tell a soul. Keep it for yourself. Got it?
What? You keeping it?
Well, goodbye, sir.
Goodbye. Or until next time. And good evening.
What happened to this rug?
Oh, it's when we got a call yesterday. I asked the young man to fill the pile. Came back to put it down, but his feet were covered in soot and he made a black print. Madame Bella said it was my fault and I got a shilling's penalty. I also have to clean the print and it's no picnic. He has immense feet, that boy.
I heard that there was a theft yesterday. Did you see anything?
No, and I was here the whole time.
Who delivers the coal?
It's never the same person. I've never seen that lad before.
Do you always keep an eye on the coat stand?
Oh, yes. Well, when the coal delivery came, a client came out of the chambers and stopped me from seeing the boy who brought the bucket of coal. You don't think he would have taken advantage?
Until next time, miss.
With pleasure, sir.
Can I go this way? Oh, that's the exit? Where the hell did I go? Alright, so what am I doing? No!
I have no reason to go that way.
Oh, thanks.
No, it would be better not to insist.
What? So where am I supposed to go?
No, it would be better not to insist.
Wait, nobody even want to murk me anyways. Okay, I don't know what I'm doing.
Good evening, Doctor. My name is Dr. Watson. Pleased to meet you.
Good evening. I am Dr. Gibbons. Likewise.
I have come to see you about one of your patients. Margie goes by the nickname Nutcracker, who gets her prescription from the clinic. She's a lady of the night and is afflicted with a venereal disease.
I know who you're talking about. Indeed, Margie has syphilis and is being treated with mercury.
Do you have her address?
No. And for your information, she left London for good 3 days ago. She felt threatened.
Margie felt threatened? But by whom?
I believe that Margie was particularly scared of a terrifying man who attacked her once.
Did she say the name Pizer or Pyther?
Unfortunately, she didn't give a name, but she described a man with shifty, rat-like eyes and a mouth twisted in a sinister grimace.
Did Margie have any idea where this man who terrified her so much might be found?
No, but she told me that another girl who'd been attacked like her had told her that this man worked in a cobbler's run by an old Israeli. Also, she saw him again last week, the night of the big fire. She told of going to see the fire like most everyone else in the area. While there, she recognised her attacker in the crowds gathered at the warehouses. There was no mistaking a face like that, she said. She kept an eye on the man the whole time the firemen were working in order to avoid him.
Goodbye, Dr. Gibbons.
Until we meet again, my dear colleague.
Okay. Who's this? I can't even talk to him. Margie? Sorry, huh?
This interview with the doctor revealed an important fact. Leather Apron could not be the Bucks Row murderer. According to Margie, the villain passed most of the night of the crime at the fire. He could not have been at the scene of the murder at the moment it was committed. He is, nonetheless, a dangerous character.
What? I didn't know I was supposed to go in there. Okay, hold on. So there's something in there to get the whole time? I didn't even know that. How the hell am I supposed to know he's supposed to open this and then... Oh, so I guess I fucked up. Maybe that's the secret achievement. No, it's a story. Matter of fact, let me talk to the doctor again.
What can I do for you, my dear colleague?
No, that's it.
Goodbye, Dr. Gibbons.
Until we meet again, my dear...
Shut up. So how does he get to open the door, but I can't? That's gay. Is he open? Oh, he's still closed.
Yes, my lord.
I have no reason to go that way.
Alright, let me check the dialogue.
I have no reason to go that way.
Yeah, I don't know where I'm going. I don't think I'm missing something. Why are you walking like that?
Tell me, is it? I was in Crimea, I was, sir, and you owe me some respect.
All right, dude.
No reason to go that way.
Yeah, I'm kind of stomped. So after the clinic, what am I supposed to do? I can't even open that door. Let me just try to get that shit out the way.
What can I do for you, my...
Goodbye, Dr. Gibbon.
Until we meet...
No, not this. It. So why can't I open this? Oh my god. I think I must have forgotten something. Oh!
A large black footprint.
Maybe that's something to do with anything.
What can I do for you, my dear colleague?
There we go.
Pardon me, Doctor, but who made the large black footprints there near the beds?
The brother of one of my patients. The poor thing had a leg amputated after colliding with a carriage. We arranged to find her a prosthesis.
Prostheses are very expensive. How did this man pay?
He told me that one of his uncles gave him a walking stick with a chiseled silver knob. I agreed to accept this knob in exchange for a simple prosthesis with harness. But this object is of great value, and I could finance half a dozen other prostheses by selling it on Petticoat Lane.
Doctor, I have reason to believe that the silver knob that you possess is from a cane that was stolen by the man who brought it to you. And I believe I know to whom it belongs.
That's what I was worried about. The story of the uncle seemed a little strange. Nevertheless, you must have proof of what you claim. I will show you all of the knobs that we have here. If you find the knob that the young man gave me, I will believe you.
So be it, but something is bothering me. I will need a complete cane, not just a knob.
Don't worry, dear chap, build one. I can loan you some tools. Make use of the odds and ends in my cupboard. It'll help get rid of it.
Well, I shall try. I will have to remember the description that Sickert gave. Goodbye, Dr. Gibbons.
Until we meet again, my dear colleague.
It's okay, I'm about to cheat anyways. So let's go to the cane to this real quick. Okay, so... 4... 3... Last one, and then 4.
There, all done. Holmes couldn't have done better himself.
Methodical.
What can I do for you, my dear colleague?
Oh my god, more.